you followed all Kivy and Buildozer setup instructions meticulously. Yet, after countless repeats and endless hours of building and testing your APK, your app still crashes at startup, leaving you tired and running out of ideas. If this sounds familiar to you, maybe this video can help save time and help you focus faster on what matters most, that is, your app. Today, I will share a few tips around Kivy and Buildozer configuration to help avoid some common issues that can be hard to detect. First tip, use the Logcat debug logs. Without these logs, I was flying blind, and I cannot emphasize enough how helpful the debug logs are for troubleshooting crashes. It's through debug logs I learned that even to run my basic Hello World type application, I need modules Pillow and Kivy. That error message, or this one, that error with import, or that I need a specific version of KivyMD and Cython. I prefer testing my APK with Android Studio on Windows. Now, this is a free app. I've posted the URL here. To filter log messages from only your app, number one, configure Buildozer spec with your app name, like so. And number two, once you bring up your device emulation on Android Studio, click the tab Logcat and apply a filter with your app name. And there you go. Okay, so from debug log, I learned that to make my basic Hello World application work, I have to install or correctly configure a list of modules. This leads to my second tip. Start with a simple minimal app that uses only those modules that your debug log showed are missing or misconfigured. These modules are more likely to cause APK crashes upon startup. Make sure these essential modules are correctly set up. A properly working build environment is absolutely critical before anything. Otherwise, you cannot build on more complex stuff in your app. Dedicate a folder in your build machine for this minimal app. I'm using Ubuntu 22.04.3 LTS on Oracle VirtualBox for my Buildozer build machine. I'll call this folder My App. It should contain Python script for my basic app and any other files that it needs. By the way, the file that contains our main Python program should always be named main.py for Buildozer to work. My basic app main.py requires a Kivy design file for graphical components. It is named My Simple App. And sure, the case and naming of this Kivy design file follows Buildozer requirements. Other than main.py and mysimpleapp.kivy, there is another file in my app folder, buildozers.spec, which was generated after Buildozer was initialized. Let us look at the first module that requires a proper setup. It deals with imaging functions, which are important for the graphical interfaces of our app. Check if module Pillow, which helps Python handle imaging libraries, is correctly installed. In my case, it was installed, but I still wanted to verify version compatibility with 3.10.12, which was my Python version. Version compatibility is available here. To check the pillow version installed, run the command as shown on your screen. Mine showed pillow version 9.0.1, which according to the table here, is compatible with Python 3.10.12. Make sure that pillow is added to the requirements in buildozer.spec, like so. Next, we need to install Kivy. Uninstall all Kivy-related libraries you already have installed. Use a virtual environment for the new install wherever Kivy documentation recommends this. I strongly recommend understanding virtual environments before installation. Maybe you want to read up this and this. Basically, a virtual environment helps isolating and preventing conflict between different versions of the same package needed by your apps. As on date, if you install Kivy from a precompiled wheel from the official website, you will get version 2.2.1. But you may need a specific Kivy version that works for your code, and it may not be the latest one. For the Kivy version you need, you also have to ensure that you're installing a compatible version of Cython. To force Buildozer to pick your desired Kivy version, head to the requirements section of buildozer.kv, specify Kivy, and I needed Kivy version 2.2.0 and Cython version 0.29.33. I manually installed Cython version 0.29.33 with command. Next, we check the installation for KivyMD. KivyMD is a collection of material design compliant widgets for use with touch-enabled graphical applications which are built on Kivy. I ran the command pip install pip install KivyMD to install KivyMD. As KivyMD was previously installed, I just needed to check KivyMD version number 1.1.1 was compatible with my Kivy. Don't forget to add KivyMD in the requirements in Buildozer spec. With all essential modules in place, it is time to share my fifth and final tip. If your Android app requires or will require in future an access permission from the user, for example, to the microphone, you need to add some permission-related code and configuration. Some sample code is here. Open up main.py. We need to set up imports for Android permissions. Then head to the method that implements the permissions dialog. We need to implement a permission callback method, and the name of this method in my sample code is permission callback. So this permission callback method needs to be registered, and its implementation is here. And here is some configuration in buildozer.spec. Head to the permissions section in buildozer.spec. Specify the permissions you need. Include these changes to your basic minimal app and make sure they work correctly. This can save you time and effort later when you eventually need to work with user inputs and you require the user to give permission to collect those inputs. Sometimes, in spite of taking all necessary steps, your app still doesn't launch or run properly. In those cases, it may be required to update p4a.fork. By the way, p4a stands for Python for Android. Section for p4a.fork can be located in buildozer.spec. So it may be required to update p4a.fork and or p4a.branch sections for your specific need. These sections are found in the buildozer.spec file. I recommend doing a buildozer android clean followed by buildozer-v android debug to clean build your APK. Doing a clean build can take a long time, sometimes well over an hour, so use it only when necessary. So there you go. Those were my 5 starter tips to correctly set up a Kivy Buildozer environment for your Python Android development. What other steps can be added to make this setup process even smoother? Share your tips and comments in the comment box down below. Please like and share with your friends my video and do subscribe if you like my content. Thank you for watching. Let's do a quick build with debug option and load the APK on the Android Studio emulator and test it.